Below is a drawing of vectors u, v, and w. Sort the cards according to the quantity they represent. If a card doesn't represent any of the quantities, it should be left unsorted. So let's see what they have over here. So this, they've drawn vector v here in blue, vector w here in magenta, and then vector u here in purple. And so let's see what the choices, are. The rectangular coordinates 3, 4. So if we go 3 along the x axis in the positive direction, and then we go up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, we get to the head of vector v, and its tail, it started at the origin. So this could right over here represent vector v. If we say, hey, look, the tail of our vector is going to be at the origin, then this coordinate right over here represents the head of a vector. This could be a representation for vector v. Another way to think about it is vector v, from its tail, goes 3 in the horizontal direction and 4 in the vertical direction. So that's another way to think about it. So I would say that's definitely a representation of vector v. Now let's see, the number 5. Well, the number 5 won't represent a vector. This is just a number. This could be a magnitude, but to be a vector, we need a magnitude and a direction. But right over here, we have the magnitude of vector v. So let's think about whether 5 could be the magnitude of vector v. If 5 is the magnitude, it would be the length of this vector. And we could think about that from the Pythagorean theorem. This side right over here has length 3. That side over there has length 4. You might recognize this as a 3, 4, 5 triangle. Or another way to think about it, if we use the Pythagorean theorem, 3 squared is 9, plus 4 squared, plus 16 is 25, which is going to be this magnitude squared. So the magnitude of vector v is 5. So we could throw that right over here. The magnitude of vector v is 5, or you could say the length of this, well, I guess how we've depicted the vector. Now let's look at vector u. Well, vector u is just a shifted representation of vector v. Notice, if we start at its tail, you move 3 to the right and 4 up. 3 to the right and 4 up. So vector u is really the same thing as vector v. We don't care about where they start. We just care about how much do they, from the tail to the head, how much do you move in the horizontal direction and how much do you move in the vertical direction. And for both of them, you move positive 3 in the horizontal and positive 4 in the vertical. So vector u really is the same thing as vector v, if we're thinking in vector terms. Now vector w, this, if we start at the tail to go to the head, we have to go negative 3 in the x direction and negative 4 in the y direction. So vector w is the negative of vector v or the negative of vector u, but it's not equal to either one of them. So we're all done. We have set up, these are the quantities that are in the appropriate buckets.